Dear students, welcome to the first lecture of Digital Image Processing. This lecture focuses on the introduction of digital image processing, where you will study about the basics of DIP. Upon the completion of this lecture, you will be able to understand the concept of digital images, purpose of image processing, and the methods used in image processing. In digital image processing, basically there are three terms: digital, image, and processing. So DIP is a processing of image which is digital in nature by a digital computer. What is the motivation behind digital image processing? Images which are digital in nature, they have various advantages. It gives us the improvement of pictorial information, so it is clearly visual and information can be extracted very easily. For digital images, transmission is very fast and it gives us efficient storage, security is also very high. So these are the factors behind this. You will study about image. What is digital image? A simple image model, what is image processing, purpose of image processing, and the methods used for image processing. So let us start one by one. What is an image? We encounter images everywhere in our daily life. We see many visual information sources like painting, drawing, sketching, image gallery, internet, advertisement boards, newspaper, TV, etc. So images is a representation of something or someone or an idea you are picturing or the way you think. Images are very powerful tool in communication. Images may be of two types. It may be a black and white image, it may be a colored image. Here you can see two images of a flower. This is black and white image and this is color image. How black and white image is being processed, how color image is being processed, how to calculate the memory requirement, we'll study in the coming classes. Image can be defined as a two-dimensional function fxy, where x and y are the spatial coordinates, and the amplitude of f at any pair of coordinate xy is known as intensity or gray level of the image in that particular point. Here you can see two images of a same girl, but in first case coordinate is x0, y0, while in second case coordinate is x1, y1. So f of x0, y0 will give the intensity level of this pixel, and f of x1, y1 will give us the intensity level of this coordinate, which is x1, y1. How to represent it mathematically? If we are writing f of 1, 1 is equal to 103, then 1, 1 it represents the pixel location, and 103 gives us the pixel intensity value. It means 1, 1 is x, y, this coordinate, and 103 is the intensity level of that particular. What is digital image? When x, y, and fxy, all these three terms are finite and discrete quantities, then that image is known as a digital image. Digital image is composed of finite number of elements, each of which has a particular location and value. Location means coordinate and value means intensity level. These elements are known as picture elements, image elements, pels or pixels, where pixels is the most widely used term. Here also you can see an image of a girl and its digital form is being also represented in the another. representation, how to represent it. Images can be represented in the form of the matrix. Here you can see that a digital image is being represented, two-dimensional digital image with m rows and n columns. Like if we take this particular coordinate, its coordinate will be 2, 2, and the value means f of 2, 2 will gives us the value of intensity at this point. If we take this pixel, intensity at this pixel may vary from the intensity of this pixel. Each and every pixel is represented by k bits. Therefore, a pixel can have 2^k different values. If we say k is equal to 8, then 2^8 possible values means it is coming out as 256. It means total 256 levels exist. 256 levels. If we talk about black and white images, 0 can be represented by black level and 255 level, which is the uppermost, it can be represented by white level. In between 0 to 255, there will be various shades of gray. A simple image model. Image must be compatible for computer processing. This is the first and foremost requirement. And image which is represented by fxy in two dimensional, it must be digitized both in spatial domain and in amplitude domain. When the digitization of image is being done in a spatial domain, it is known as image sampling, while digitization in amplitude is known as gray level quantization. You will study in detail in the coming lectures. Here an image is being taken where digitization implies that a digital image is an approximation of a real scene. Original image and its digital image is being represented. What is image processing? Image processing is a method of converting an image into digital form, where certain operations can be performed so that we may get enhanced image at the output, or we should be able to extract some useful information from it. Image processing is a type of signal dispensation where input is the image while output may be an image or the characteristics or the attributes of the image. Image processing is a rapidly growing technology. Today, it has applications in almost all the areas of engineering and computer science discipline too. There are three basic steps via which each and every image has to undergo during the processing. First is importing the image. Image importing is done via image acquisition tool. Then analyzing and manipulating the image. And output stage, third stage is image analysis, from where the information or the interpretation is being done. There is a continuous improvement, development from image processing to the computer vision, and this whole development can be broken up into three categories: low level process, mid level process and high level process. In low level process, input is image, output is also image. While in mid level process, input is image, output is attributes. Means from the image itself, its characteristics or the attributes needs to be extracted. While in high level process, input is attribute, while output is the understanding. like identifying what is the situation of scene, what could be the situation of surrounding, navigation. So these are the three level processes. What is the purpose of image processing? The purpose of image processing is divided into five groups. These groups are visualization, image sharpening and restoration, image retrieval, measurement of pattern, and image recognition. Visualization is observing the image which is not clearly visible. That is visualization. Image sharpening and restoration is required to create a better image. If it is not clearly visible, it needs to be sharpened and restored so that it can be clearly visualized and further operations can be performed. Image retrieval is seeking the image of interest. Image may be a very large image, where our area of interest may be a very small portion. So extracting or identifying that particular area is known as the image retrieval. Measurement of pattern. Measuring various objects in an image. In an image, there may be various objects like circle, triangle, rectangle. So measuring circle, triangle and rectangle all together, via which information needs to be processed, is the measurement of pattern. And the last is image recognition. Image recognition is distinguishing the objects in a nature. Sometimes it may happen that because of poor image quality, square and rectangle may look like similar. So on the basis of the coordinates, its gray level, intense, which is the intensity level, and other characteristics, objects distinguishing needs to be done. That is the image recognition. So these are the five basic purpose of image processing. Methods used for image processing. You have heard about analog and digital, two terms. Accordingly, in image processing, there are two methods, analog image processing and digital image processing. Analog image processing is image processing task conducted on two-dimensional analog signals by analog means. Here, images are manipulated by electrical signals. Examples of analog image processing is television image, medical images, etc. Digital image processing is applied to digital images for analyzing and manipulating the images. Digital image processing improves the digital quality of image and intensity level of the pixels within the image. Digital image processing is very cheap and faster in comparison to the analog signal processing. While there are three general phases that all the data of digital image processing have to undergo while using this technique: pre-processing, enhancement in display, and information extraction. This is the pre-processing is related to the input image. Enhancement in display to process via channel. Enhancement and display, it needs to be done. And information extraction, this is related to the output of the image. Here you can see there are two images. In the first one, a letter T is being written. It's digitized form is being represented in the form of the matrix, where 1 is being written for white pixels and 0 is being written for the black. You can see, if we draw the black one, see, T is being formed. So this is being represented into the digital form. Here a person scan is being represented over here, its digital form, and in the form of the matrix also it is being represented. In matrix, it is a 4x4. First coordinate will be 1, 1, and 56 is the intensity level of this particular coordinate. For this particular coordinate, its value is 2, 2, and f of 2, 2 will gives us the value of intensity level of this particular coordinate, which is 56. So this is the way via which digital images have been represented. Thank you, students. For any query, you may write me on the mentioned email ID. Thank you so much.